Until now, if one wanted to have small detail for one's layout, the possibilities were limited. One could either buy these, sculpt them, or build them. In recent years, 3D printing became a thing, but unless you are good at 3D modeling, complex objects were out of reach or had to be downloaded from a website. But now that problem has been solved. You can easily 3D scan objects. This is the first part in a series to show you how to do that. 3D scanning isn't a new thing. I worked on projects about it at my previous job nearly 20 years ago, but it was not user-friendly and extremely expensive. As graphic cards became more powerful, open source software started to show up, but they were difficult to use and required a very beefy machine. About half a year ago, I stumbled on the app Polycam, which allows to do 3D scans with your smartphone, and it's really easy to use. The app has two modes, photo and LiDAR. The LiDAR mode requires a smartphone with a LiDAR, like one from Apple's iPhone Pro series. For this tutorial, I will be using an iPhone 13 Pro. This mode is free as it is processed on the phone itself. In photo mode, you need to take at least 50 to 250 images of an object. These images are sent to the server where they are processed. This service requires you to buy a subscription from Polycam if you want to do many scans or with greater details. Another advantage of photo mode is that you don't need a smartphone. You can use it from Polycam's website where you can upload images from any cameras. We will show this feature in a future video and we'll show how to scan buildings. So, for this tutorial you will need a smartphone, the Polycam app, Blender, this is a free 3D software, a computer which can run Blender, a slicer software like G2Box, a 3D printer, and optionally an airbrush to paint the model. As you see, these are not the regular Modelrailroad tools. From one dealer I hear that he has to reprogram a lot of addresses in locomotives because that's too difficult and scary. So this tutorial is going to be really scary, especially if you have never seen this kind of software. The first time I used a 3D modeling software was in 1997, on a computer with 32 MB RAM. The one I'm using now has 64 GB, which is 2048 times more. If you look for the older video on this channel, you will find some animated movie I did over 10 years ago. Check the link in the box. I will assume you know how to use your 3D printer and the slicer software, otherwise check for tutorials. In the next part we will show you how to scan people, large structure and extremely small pieces. The first step is to find an object we want to scan. For this tutorial we are looking for objects which are between 1 and 5 meters in size. The following type of objects won't work: highly reflective objects, glass, water also when not moving, trees, in general large object with very fine structure. It works generally the best with organically shaped objects. For objects with regular shapes like a trash bin, it's better to create it directly on the computer. So now fire up the Polycam app, choose either photo or LiDAR mode. Walk around the object to capture it from every angle, don't forget from under. If the object is tall, bring a ladder or a selfie stick. When done, process the scan in the LiDAR mode on the phone. Go to custom setting, then choose range to 1 to 2 meters depending on the size of an object. Select the smallest voxel size, then start processing the object. It will take several minutes, so be sure to have enough battery when doing that. When finished, upload the model to the Polycam website. If you use photo mode, wait until you have a VLAN connection to send everything to the server, as it can quickly be 500 MB or more. Select RAW mode and object masking. So now the steps are the same for both modes. Go to the Polycam website, select your scan and download it as GLTF. Start Blender. When the default scene opens, click on the cube and delete it. Now go to Import and select the file you just downloaded. Change to texture mode so it's easier to see what you are doing. At the moment, the object is made of several mesh pieces, which have to be merged. So do following steps. Change to edit mode. Now go to select, then select by weight and non-manifold. That selects some vertices on the edges. Next go to mesh, then merge, and then merge by distance. This merges the vertices which overlaps, thus making the object as one. Now we have to remove the surrounding of the objects we don't want. For that we are using sculpting mode. We use a box trim mode to remove superfluous parts of the scan. For round stuff you can also use the lasso trim. Think like freeing an object in Photoshop, but in 3D. Sometimes the trim fails. Then go to edit mode and select faces. Select the faces you want to remove and delete them. Unfortunately, there seems to be a bug here, as this process will require more and more memory so that your computer might run out. In this case, save the file, close and reopen Blender. On the signpost, I use sculpting mode to accentuate some details, or stay visible in HO scale. When you are done, export the object to STL and load it into your slicer software. As you see from the result, not all objects are suitable for this method. The box became the best, but some details are just too small for HO scale. The signpost is okay, but needs a bit more work to be printable. The rusty pipe was a complete failure. It was very difficult to extract the object and the walls are just too thin. It's certainly possible to fix the model to make it printable, but that requires extra skills which will be outside the scope of that tutorial. A signpost can easily be fixed by adding a box on the backside and putting it in shape, so that this section gets thicker. The next print was good. Now it's just to paint it with an airbrush. Here also some scans which didn't work out. For example, this children's playground construction. All the ramps are gone, probably because it moved slightly, and the reflective bars have a lot of problems. In this case, it's probably quicker to remodel it than trying to fix that. Next, I try this set of trash containers. The surface is very reflective, so the leader scan was a complete failure. The photo mode didn't fare much better. Here also an example where I try to scan plants. They end up in blobs. Also, I wasn't able to reach some parts with the lidar. Also, these three benches have their issue, none got particularly good. Also, there is a gap between the sheets. This is also a case which would be better to remodel in the computer specially, as it can be modeled with just boxes, cylinders and spheres. Similar issue I had with this small bridge specially, as the underside was not really accessible. On the other hand, I had great results with these three stumps, both in lidar and photo mode. It's just a shame that all small details got lost when trying to print it to scale. As you see, 3D scanning works in some cases and can give great results, but you need to experiment a lot to get the best results. So that's for today. If you haven't done so, then subscribe to this channel so you won't miss out on the next video in that series where we will show you how to scan other kind of objects. We also have a Facebook page for bonus content, and check our Discord if you want to chat with us.